Hi you guys, it is Sierra and welcome back to my channel. I am currently testing a new microphone, so we will see how this audio goes over. I have the little Yeti book right here, or a little pamphlet, because I want to make sure this sounds good for you guys. But I do a lot of sit down talks and I just really wanted to invest in the audio. So you guys, please let me know down below if this is actually going to be something that works or if I need to try something else. And you might be noticing that I am recording in a slightly different setting and I'm super stoked. I'm on my little bar, seating area on my little kitchen island, and it's been so cool being in the new apartment, being able to have this space, my own space where nobody else is going to tamper with it. I know this season is going to be a sweet one because I'm hoping one day to be married and have kids and a husband, but this season of singleness, I have just been loving it because I used to want to get out of that season. I was always looking for a relationship or someone to be with, and the Lord has just satisfied that place in my life, and it's been really cool to honestly enjoy the season. It's been very interesting because I remember in the beginning of the season, it was really hard and I hated it. I didn't like it at all. I remember just thinking there's no way that I can do this for longer than 6 months to a year. I want to find that guy. And now I'm just like, Lord, like take your time because I know everything is a season in life and I'm just loving this season and I'm thankful. And I hope that you guys can experience that too. And I wanted to share with you guys five things that God has done in my life to change my mindset and my relationships and my outlook in life. And I figured what better way than to kind of talk about relationships. And I think you guys have seen, if you're a subscriber on this channel, if you're new, I do have a video up about what it was like growing up without having a father figure, or I should say my father, my biological dad. And I had a father figure. My grandpa and my uncle were great father figures, and they still are that for me to this day. And it was just something that has so radically changed my life in many different ways. And, you know, I used to look at it in a really bad, negative way, and it definitely is something that's life-altering. I would never wish growing up fatherless on anybody because it does affect your relationships. It does affect how you date people, who you date, how you date. And, you know, people say things about, you know, girls having daddy problems, and they don't lie. That's a real thing. God didn't intend for a child to be brought up by only a mother or only a father. He intended both of those people as a unit to raise and form and really impress values upon the children. And not even just values, but people and children and humans, we need both a male and female role in our lives. And that's something that in my relationships, God, this last year just really radically changed. And I think it's been great to be in a season of singleness because I'm seeing all the things and all the flaws in my past dating relationships. And I thank God for, you know, the experience that I've had and the relationships I have had. But I also thank God that I'm no longer in those relationships. No offense to anybody or any of those people. But I just see the way that I chose to date, the people that I chose to date. And I was looking to validate myself. I was looking to have like this person that was going to be able to take care of me either like, you know, emotionally or spiritually, or, you know, if I was going to be able to like be a stay-at-home mom, if they were going to be able to be like a good quality provider. And this is actually so interesting because all these things I've actually thought of many times. I'm super self-aware. I don't even know if a self-aware person would say that. Kind of sounds like a bit boastful, but I really do overanalyze everything and I really tend to look deeply into everything. And I've just noticed those things and I really am like, wow, like how incredible is it that God's been able to transform my heart and give me the eyes to see like my faults and my shortcomings in my past dating relationships. And it's a good thing because now I have great Christian men in my life that are committed fathers, committed husbands, you know, really outstanding men. And I just am so thankful because for many years I did struggle with that. And that's something that the Lord has been able to and continues to heal in my life. And I'm sure He's going to continue to heal that because I think that a lot of times we think I'm going to overcome this and then I'm going to never struggle with it again. But I just don't think that's the truth. I think that, you know, if you have a flesh wound, it's going to heal, but it's still going to have a scar. And there's nothing wrong with continuing to now and then struggle with things like that because we're human. And until we get to heaven, we are still going to have the repercussions of sin. And that's okay. That's why we have our loving Lord and Savior to nurture us and to bear our burdens and to be yoked to Him so that we can withstand all these things that we go through in relationships. And if that's something that you can relate to, I really truly pray that God would restore that relationship, an aspect of healing so that you can eventually become the woman that God intended you to be. So then you can have a relationship where you can bear fruit and do it the way that God intended and not the way that you intend, because sometimes those are two very different things, right? Another thing that I've noticed in a way that God's changed my mentality in my relationships is with my immediate family. So I remember when I was younger and I was still struggling, like in high school and right after high school, I really struggled with my family relationship. And a little bit of background on me is I grew up in multiple families. I was always with my mom, but she was married twice. And then I had a lot of issues with my own immediate family because of decisions that I made. And in high school, I started drinking, I started smoking, and that's part of my testimony at a really young age, at like 16. And I started dating a guy. Again, my choices in men were not always great, but you know what? That's part of my testimony. And I know some of you girls will be able to relate to that. So I don't shy away from sharing it. I know my future husband's going to see that and he's going to value what the Lord has worked out in my life and see that. And I trust that the Lord's going to be good and give me a loving and merciful and graceful husband one day. And, you know, we really had a rift in our family. It wasn't good at home. There was a lot of issues between my mom and her stephusband, and they're no longer together, which is unfortunate, but I see my Lord and Savior, He's restoring my mother and my sister, even my half-sister Daisy, who is my whole sister. I love her. If you're ever watching these, Daisies, I love you. And, you know, now we had a lot of problems in our relationships. We had many issues, and a lot of it stemmed from my pride, my ego, my selfish ways and not being forgiving, being unforgiving, but also like with my mom and my sister, with those two particular relationships in my immediate life, that was something that I had to give to the Lord and submit to Him because there was many things that I felt bitter about in my relationship with my mom. And it's like really interesting because I remember the Lord putting it distinctly on my heart. Like I would have never thought this on my own in my own bitterness and sulking that I was now not only not going to have a relationship with my biological father who was never in my life, but I wasn't going to ever have a relationship with my mom if I didn't swallow my pride and ego and go to her in humility and apologize and forgive her and tell her that I forgive her. And that was like something that I'm so grateful for, that the Lord spoke into my life and He just radically changed that. And to this day, I can see our relationship deepening and growing and just healing. And I'm so thankful because I love my mom, but there's so many things that when we make the wrong choices in life, the sinful choices that are rooted in our flesh and our desires of our heart, which aren't always good, there's a lot of negative repercussions on most times, if not all those relationships that are really close to us. The most sincere relationships we have are oftentimes the ones that are affected the most, whether good or bad. And that's another thing that has totally changed in my life that the Lord's been able to work out. Another thing that the Lord has been able to restore, I would say, is definitely my thoughts on what my life should look like and what I should care about in my life. So I used to be very caught up in my job and in my career. And I think it's, it's definitely not a bad thing to be ambitious and to be driven. And I've said this in videos and I'll say it again, God made us as creative beings to go to create. We're made in His image and He is the creator of the universe. We were definitely made to go and just produce and labor. And there's nothing wrong with that. But for a long time, when I was going through a really big season of challenges in my post-graduation of high school life, I just totally engulfed myself in this identity of my career, making money, being a boss, being, all these things. And like looking back, it's so crazy because I genuinely thought that that was the number one thing that I should care about. And I didn't even see that my identity was so wrapped up in that. And that's why as believers, and now my mind is so different, is because when we wrap ourselves in anything that's not identity found in Christ, what He thinks of us, we can get so off course so easily. And I'm so thankful that now my identity is in Christ alone. And I don't put my identity in my career like I used to. Yes, I still have my business. I do housekeeping. And then I also do commercial cleaning, which is awesome. It's great. I love my job. The Bible even tells us that one of the joys that we do get to experience on this earth is actually eating the produce and reaping the produce of our own labors. Like, that is a good thing. That's not a bad thing at all. You shouldn't be ashamed of having money or working hard or having a successful business. Those are all things that we can use to edify, glorify the Lord. But definitely, it's something we can so easily put our entire identity behind. And that's a huge thing that the Lord has been able to change. And also, I would say my relationship and my outlook on my relationships with women have changed. I remember growing up, like at a young age, and even like in high school, and sometimes even after I graduated from high school, up until like honestly, like this last like 2 years, I don't know what it was. I just had a very bad taste in my mouth of like girls and like women. I think probably some of it stemmed from trauma and some things that I've been through early on in my life that have just scarred me. But I just had a really negative outlook on like female friends and female relationships. And God has really restored that because I look now and I see the women that I'm surrounded by and I just thank God because I have such quality girlfriends. And, they're few and far between because I think finding a friend is so rare that you can connect with and love. And I am so thankful that now I can have good relationships with other women around me that are better than me, that are smarter than me, that are wiser than me, that are better off than me in life, because I love seeking those women for advice and having a council of specifically women to kind of use as a sounding board, but also like the camaraderie of having female friends is nothing like going and, seeking out relationships in men. And that's something I think that I really struggled with was I was so intact and seeking out a relationship with men that I never in my life until the last 2 years or even year have prioritized any female friendships. My entire identity also is found in seeking out my relationship and who I was dating. And that was king in my life. Like the person that I'm very much the type of woman that when I'm in a relationship, like I am wholeheartedly committed to you. I will give my time to you 100%. Like I would rather hang out with you than with my girlfriends. And I don't even think that those are bad things because if you're married or engaged to or dating a godly Christian man, like you should be prioritizing a relationship, but you should also have rich, deep relationships with women around you. And that was never something, and I regret, honestly, that is a regret that I have, not investing in female friends during many of these chapters in my life, because I see the value in it now. And with a couple friends in particular, And even my cousin, like the closest girls around me, like I could not get through life without them. Like I love the relationships that we have. They're so sweet. They make me laugh. Like they bring so much joy into my life. And I am so thankful. And I just wish I would have like done that, you know, earlier and like gotten over these things. But God puts us through and allows us to walk through, because I put myself through many of the things I've gone through in life. But he allows us to go through what we go through so we can have these realizations and then value what he's restored in our life so deeply. And then also, I think one thing that God like restored and a way that he brought like deeper relationships into my life is through service. And one thing that I was listening to in one of our young adult services, which are really amazing. We have a great young adults program at our church. It's ages 18 to 25. We meet on Monday night at 7. It's at Wildwood Calvary. If you're in Southern California, I would highly recommend you come. We have two amazing pastors. They both work together for our young adults program. John Fossio and Lincoln Seepley. They're so good. But John was preaching and he was talking about like, if you really are following Jesus, or if you want to like serve, or if you want to be a pastor, if you're called to ministry, like you are called to serve. And that's not like, you know, something to be looked down upon. Like Jesus came to this earth to serve us. Jesus came to die for our sins, to serve us. The good thing that we received, our salvation in Jesus Christ, like he is literally a king and the creator of the entire universe, yet he put himself as a lowly carpenter, so humbled, being criticized his entire life, and yet he still had a servant-hearted mindset. And I think this year it's been really cool to see, like in my business, in my friendships, in my family, I've really tried to take on more of like a servant attitude. And from what I found, when you serve people, like serving others cures anxiety. And I have found this to be true. Serving others cures fear. Serving others cures so many things, because when we're so focused on ourselves, it's so easy to have anxiety. It's so easy to have fear. It's so easy to get wrapped up in all these things. And the second that you start serving others, God will fulfill you in a way that you can't explain. Like, I can't even tell you the amount of times that I've gone in to serve, whether it be for worship or just like serving a friend and like doing something for a friend. And, you know, there's things in my life that I have anxiety over, or like fear, or just things that I shouldn't be worried about, or I'm worrying too much about. And serving others brings like restoration that I can't even explain to your mind. And it's really interesting, because I just really can't believe that that's the case. Because you think, oh, well, if I have anxiety, if I have fear, you know, I should focus on myself. That's what the world will tell you. The world will tell you me, 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 self, 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 self. But the truth behind that is a lie. That's not true. When we focus on ourselves, that is honestly when things tend to go downhill. We need to focus on others. And not that we shouldn't take care of ourselves, and not that we shouldn't do the appropriate things to take care of us mentally, physically, emotionally, but it changes things and it changes your mind, and it just transforms you when you step into an attitude of being servant-minded. And it's a beautiful thing that you experience when you participate in. And, you know, it's really easy to make that the last priority, because life is busy. You know, there's seasons in my life where I'm like, oh, I can't serve. I'm too busy. I'm working. You know, I have another client. I got another job. And it's like, when I get in those seasons and I take a break from ministry, I have more fear and I'm less happy in the seasons where I'm prioritizing serving on a continual basis, even though I'm still just as busy. I am so much more happy and so much more fulfilled and so much more satisfied knowing that I am serving and I am investing in the kingdom, right? Because it's like we invest in all these things, but it's like, when are you investing in God's kingdom? Like, you're not going to take any of this stuff with you. You're not going to take your job. You're not going to take your finances. You're not going to take whatever it is. You're not going to take your own body. Like, if you're, you know, focused on taking care of yourself first, you're taking your spirit, and when we invest into the kingdom, you guys, we're going to see that in heaven. We're going to see that. We're going to see the produce of reaping into God's kingdom. And it's incredible, you guys. If you struggle with anxiety or fear or depression, I promise you, you'll see a change in your happiness and joy and being blessed in your life that you could not even imagine. And it's just incredible, you guys. And those are the top five things that I've seen God transform in my life, transform relationships, transform my mind, transform everything that I am. Every time that I have an interaction with Jesus, I'm changed. And that's what I really hope and pray that you guys would see, is that a relationship with Jesus changes you, and you are not the same as when you started that, you know, relationship with Jesus and ended it, or when you opened your Bible and when you closed it, or when you were praying in your car. You're not the same. And there's just a life-changing alteration from every single interaction with Jesus. And I get emotional talking about it because I remember the times in my life where I wasn't living like this, and I never want to go back. I never want to go back, because the things that the Lord has done in my life and in healing me and in transforming me, I want all of you to experience that. And that's what God wants for you. God wants that for you. He doesn't want you to fall into the same generational curses. He wants to break your chains and set you free from all of the addictions and pain and trauma and suffering that you've gone through in your life. He desires to take all of those burdens, even the ones you don't think you have. Guys, there's things that I thought I was like so good. And the more that I know the Lord, the more that I realize like I'm such a sinner. Like I'm such a sinner. I'm such a broken mess. But it's like there's so much beauty in a relationship and walking with the Lord, because it's like, okay, yeah, I'm a sinner and I'm broken. But like the point of the relationship with the Lord is that He saves us, but then He restores us. Like He's not gonna see you and leave you the same. Like He's the potter, right? Like if He sees you and you meet Him and you're just like this broken pot and like all these millions of pieces, He will pick every single one of those up and put it together. And by the time you're back together, you're going to be even more beautiful than you were before. And you might still see a couple scars. You might still see a couple little flakes that came off, right? But they're back. But you are more beautiful, and God values all the things that you've gone through, and He would love to heal and restore those things, because He loves you enough that He sent His one and only Son, the only one He had, the creator of the universe. Imagine sending somebody you love to die, to be sacrificed, to be murdered, to be ripped apart on a cross, laughed at, embarrassed. You guys, like people were like throwing like fecal matter on Him. Like the person that you love the most, imagine sending them willingly to go and just be publicly scrutinized and torn to shreds and eventually murdered. He loved you that much so that you could have an atonement for your sins and be restored completely. He will turn a heart of stone into a heart of flesh, and He will make a cloth that is crimson into as white as snow. And I've seen it in my life, and I know this is true. And if you're thinking this is too good to be true, if you seek the Lord, those who seek the Lord will find Him. If you seek the Lord earnestly and you genuinely want to find Him, He will reveal Himself. And many people will tell you that, oh, well, you know, that's not true. I've read through the whole Bible, this or that. Well, were you reading through the whole Bible as an academic thing for yourself, or were you actively seeking a relationship with the Lord? Because I guarantee you, and I promise on my own life, on everything that I have, if you seek Jesus and you want to experience that transformation, and if you're open to that, I know that the Holy Spirit will speak to you out of 100% guarantee. He will transform you and He will touch you. And the Lord will plant seeds throughout our lives, like He did in mine, that are just undeniable. Things that He's done in my life, I know He's real. I know that God is real. I believe Him. There's so many things that I've gone through that are unexplainable, that God has reached out and grasped me when I was in my trespasses, dead in sin, worthless to the world. God was like, I love you. I love you and I died for you and I want you and I want to restore you. I don't only want you out of a jealous love because we're his children and he loves us. He wants to restore us and bring us to a place where we can honor him and glorify him and enjoy life, guys. God doesn't just want us to get by. He wants to give us the desires of our heart. And he doesn't want you to just get by. He doesn't want you to just be healed. He wants you to be completely restored. And I hope that you guys understand. And if you don't understand, I hope that you just pray that the Lord reveals himself to you. Because if you don't understand these things I've talked about yet, it's totally okay. I think that there's like a spiritual maturity that we go through. And I just know that the Lord is working in your guys' lives. And just ask him, because there's like a spiritual wisdom that we get when we pray. Like, there's things that I've prayed about recently that I'm just like in shock that the Lord is answering, and he's like bringing these things that I said in private in my head, and he's like totally listening, right? So if you're in a position where you're like, well, I just don't know if the Lord can do that in my life, talk to God. Prayer changes everything. Like, prayer, it should be like talking to your best friend. You don't have to have your eyes closed. You don't have to be sitting. You don't have to be kneeling. I drive in my car and I probably look like a psychopath half the time. People probably think I am like literally manic. And I don't even care, because I am talking to the creator of the universe who healed my brokenness and restored me. And I love him. And I love him so much. And I just pray that you guys get to experience and cherish a relationship with the Lord, because he desires to have a relationship with you, not to just follow a religion. I think people very much get that construed in a bad light, where Christianity is a religion. Yes, it's a religion. But when you really know the Lord, it's a relationship. You can say I'm a Christian, but at the end of the day, all I have is a relationship with Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, Jehovah Jireh, because you can call it whatever you want, but I have a relationship with the creator of the universe. And you guys, that's so beautiful. That is so beautiful. It's not a religion. It's a relationship. God desires you. He loves you. He wants to do the same things that he's healed and restored in my life in you. And all you have to do is proclaim that you trust him, that you accept him into your heart, and that you are turning and repenting from your sin, and that you're choosing to follow him, and he is going to live in you, and the Holy Spirit's going to depart on you, and your life's going to change. Seek him, get in his word, open the Bible. That's how he speaks to you. He wants to speak to you. And every time that you open your word, God's word does not come back void. If you think that God's word comes back void, just wait. You're going to be in a situation where like you read something like a year ago or last week, and all of a sudden, boom, it's going to come into your mind. And it is crazy, because it's true. I have been in multiple situations where I'm like, wow, this person, like, you know, really wants me to pray for them for this. Or like, I'm in an interaction with a person, and all of a sudden, this piece of scripture comes into my mind, and I'm like, how did that even get there? Like, where did that even come from? But that's how radically God's word transforms and penetrates our heart. Is like, it's in there. Like, it's an impenetrable, indestructible seed that gets planted, and it just grows, and it's in there. It's always in there. But it's just incredible how that works. And I can rant forever. I love you guys so much. I hope that these five things that radically transformed my mindset and my life and the relationships in my life and how I deal with relationships can impact you in such a positive way. I just pray over you guys that the Lord is giving you peace, that serving may give you the ability to feel greater joy and to take away your anxiety and fear, and that you can have a personal relationship with the Lord that is so rich and deep, that grows more and more every day. And I love you guys so much. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. I love seeing your guys' comments. You guys make me so happy. I've met so many cool people from all over the world, and I want to meet you and I want to talk to you. Let me know what you got from this video, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.